Hello viewers, welcome to CSS World. In this video, our topic is national interest, so here we go. First of all, what do we mean by national interest? National interest is basically interest of a state or a nation to achieve its goals and objectives. These goals and objectives may be of any kind, including social goals, political goals, economic goals, and security objectives or goals. Keep in mind that national interest of a state is always its core value, and state never ever compromises on national interest. Definition of national interest. Although national interest is a very vague term, there is no proper and internationally accepted definition of this term, but still we can define the national interest by saying that national interest is the goal of the government for securing country's security, economic well-being, socio-cultural values, military and international political goals. Here is another definition of national interest, which is given by Vernon Vaughan. According to him, national interest is that which states seek to protect or achieve in relation to each other. It means desires on the part of sovereign states. Now we will see that how a state can achieve the national interests. Keep in mind that national interest is not something which a state can achieve directly within the short time period, but for this purpose, state sets objectives first of all, and then it pursues these objectives through its foreign policy. Let's suppose there is a state X which has its interests in state Y. Then the state X will never ever directly go for achieving its interests, but state X will make a list of objectives and then it will devise its foreign policy according to these objectives. And then the state X will achieve its interest in state Y through foreign policy tactics. Types of national interest. There are three basic types of national interests, including primary interests, secondary interests, and permanent interest. Let's study them all one by one. First one is primary interest. Primary interest of a state are those interests upon which a state never ever compromises. They include territory, nationalism, and sovereignty. These three interests are always dearest to all the states. None of the states will ever compromise on any type of territorial attack. It will actively defend its territory and will go at any length to defend its territory. So, territory is one of the primary interests of all the states. Then comes nationalism. Every state promotes its own interests worldwide. They never compromises on nationalism. They always give top priority to its own interests. Third primary interest is sovereignty. All the sovereign states of the world consider sovereignty as their supreme interest. They never accept any foreign interference in the country's own matters. The government of a state maintains its supreme rule over the state. So these all are the primary interests, and keep in mind that primary interests of a state never change. They always remain the same. Now secondary interests. Secondary interests of a state are directly related to the needs and demands of the people of that particular state. These interests are based on domestic level, but to pursue these interests, state sometimes has to take steps both at local level as well as at international level. Let's suppose economic conditions of a state X are not good and people are suffering a lot. In such a situation, the state will include this economic situation in its national interests. As a result, it will work at both the local level as well as at international level to bring the country out of this economic turmoil. Currently, Pakistan is facing the same situation, so betterment of economic conditions is its one of the top national interests. Therefore, the government is trying to take the steps accordingly. So all such interests are secondary interests, which keep on changing with the passage of time. They don't remain same like the primary interests. Third one is permanent interest. Besides the primary and secondary interest, a country also wages its permanent interests. So keep in mind that these permanent interests are always based on ideology. So it often happens that a state comes into being existence on the basis of an ideology. Or after becoming a state, it starts following an ideology. In both the cases, the state considers this ideology dearest to it. It considers this ideology as permanent interest of state. So it continues the work to promote this ideology, or at least it not miss anything to defend it. We can take an example of Cold War. This was the war between two ideologies, including communism and capitalism. USSR was promoting communism and the United States was promoting capitalism. So these both ideologies are basically their permanent interests. Now we will see that how states achieve their national interests. First way is collective security. Now what do we mean by collective security? It is basically a cooperation of several countries in an alliance to strengthen the security of each state. In such an alliance, the member states agree on certain terms and they declare something as their common goal. So they jointly do efforts to gain that goal. We can take an example of NATO. Similarly, the purpose of the League of Nations after World War I and the United Nations in the current times are also the examples of collective security. So in this way, states pursue their interests. Second way is economic aid. If a country has interests in another country, then it has an option of giving the economic aid to that particular country for getting its own interests. We can better understand it by taking an example of US-Pak relations in context with US-led Afghan war. In this situation, the interests of the United States were linked with Pakistan. As a result, throughout the US venture in Afghanistan, Pakistan has been getting aid from the United States. So economic aid is also one of the methods to achieve the national interests. Third one is diplomacy. All the countries of the world use this tool to serve their interests abroad. For this purpose, countries appoint their diplomat worldwide. They serve the interests of center country at the land of host country. Besides this, countries also play some other diplomatic cards to pursue their interests. Fourth one is alliance. Alliance is basically a union or association formed for mutual benefit, especially between countries or organizations. So by making alliance, countries come in better condition to put pressure on all the other states which are not in that alliance, and in this way they serve their interests. We can take an example of Cold War again. During the Cold War, as we have already mentioned, that there was war between two ideologies, including communism and capitalism. US was promoting capitalism and USSR was promoting communism. So both the sides were making alliances against each other. So there were two alliances during the Cold War time. So these are the four ways through which states try to achieve their national interests. Now a question arises here, that can national interest be compromised? So this question has been addressed by Hans J. Morgenthau in quite better way. According to him, national interest cannot be compromised, but compromise can be made over the objectives of national interests. From this answer, one thing is clear, that national interests can never be compromised. But this answer also told us that if there is such a situation that the objectives of the national interests may not be obtained, then these objectives can be compromised till the suitable time. But whole national interests will never ever be compromised. So this was all from today's lecture. Thanks for watching this video. Like, share, subscribe, and don't forget to press the bell icon for more videos. Goodbye.